ब्रह्मविचार सार परमाज्याम जगद्व्यापिनी ना पुस्तक धारिणी अभयताध्यांधकारापहा हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्देतां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदां तत्त्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां पुण्यां करोमि पाणिनीयप्रवेशाय रतिचित्तान्तकौमुदीम्। So we saw the Hari Shabda, then we saw the Sati Shabda. We are looking at the Sati Shabda rather. So Sati Shabda has quite a few specific sutras, and in the context of Sati Shabda we saw some important sutras. Sati Shabda by itself is difficult, and since lot of sutras apply which are specific only to Sati Shabda, those sutras can be given less importance. But in the context of Sati Shabda, we saw a lot of Paribhasha Sutras which have a lot of importance, and they apply across Prakriyas, across Tinganta, Taddhita, anything, Kridanta or even Subanta, anywhere there is a particular Paribhasha needed, then these Sutras are called for, which are covered in Subanta and Sati Shabda. Subanta Prakriya and Sati Shabda, but these sutras have wide application covered in Sati Shabda Prakriya of Laghu. So that is the importance here. And the important sutras in Sati Shabda are what we saw is Aprukta Ekal Pratya, Sarvanamasthane Cha Asambuddham is all fine, Alone Tyat Puro Upada. This Upada Sanya is important. This was in Sati Shabda. So after we ended Hari Shabda, Anangsau is specific to Sati Shabda. But Alone Tyat Puru Upada, this Upada Sanya, the definition of what is Upada is covered here. Alone Tyat Puru Upada. Upada is that letter which basically the second last letter. It is the second last letter, and how it is said, Antyat Alaha Purvaha, that which is preceding the last letter is called Upada. Then Sarvanamasthane Cha Asambuddhau, this is an important sutra. Sarvanamasthane Cha Asambuddhau, when a Sarvanamasthana Pratyaya follows in Subanta, this Upadayaha Angasya Dirgha Bhavati. This Upada is defined here, and then Angasya Dirgha when it is not in Asambuddhi, not in Sambuddhi, meaning in Asambuddhi, that means in Pullinga and Strilinga, the first five are covered, and also Sambodhana, Dvivachana and Bahuvachana. There Upada Dirgha will happen. This sutra has a pravritti there. So thereby it has wide application, but still not as important as the sutra which follows Aprukta Ekal Pratyaha, and more important Halniyabhyo Dirgha Chutisya Pruktam Hal. So Aprukta Ekal Pratyaha, a pratyaya where only a single letter remains, that is called as Aprukta, this is a Sanya Sutra. And then Halniya Abhyo Dhirgat Sutisya Pruktam Hal. Hal Lopaha, and Lopaha, although it is in first case here, that's an Adesh, and Hal is also in first case. Still we have to understand this Lopaha as a Tinganta Pada in the Vritti. So Lupyate Ityartha, Hal Lupyate, or Halaha Lopaha. So we have to understand Halaha, but if you change it to Halaha, then Sutisya Apruktasya Halaha Lopaha. So a lot of thing has to be done. Instead of that, Lopa should be understood as Lupyate. Lopa Adesha means what? Lupyate. That's how we understand. Wherever we see Lopaha and we don't see a Sashti, and Prathama is in Samanadikaran with Lopaha, it is not a definition sutra like elsewhere, but it is a Vidhi sutra, and thereby Lopa means Lupyate. Halniyabhyo Dirgha Sutisya Pruktam Hal Lupyate. The Hal which is Aprukta, meaning a single letter in a pratyaya which is not a vowel, meaning it's a consonant, and it is followed, it is following an anga which is either halanta, niyanta, abanta, dirgha or dirghat. And what will undergo lopa? Consonant. Is it any consonant? No. Sakara of su, takara of ti, or sakara of si. T and C are Ting pratyas, Su is a Subanta pratyas. I'm just covering this up again as a summary so that we know what is the importance of sakyu shabda here in laghu prakriya. And then we saw these applications of these sutras after we did sakhi. Sakhi in the sense we derived the word for which this sutra has been brought in. We saw kumari shabda as nyanta, niyanta, and then we saw avanta, khatava, and tisiyanta we didn't see. We said that since many sutras are going to be applicable here from tinganta prakriya, we'll see it then. Lagukara himself will not cover this sutra again. When he goes to tinganta, when he sees ti and si, he'll apply the sutra or he'll skip through the sutra, not even apply, he'll skip through the sutra most of the times and he'll assume that you understand this. But we'll see it then. I've marked an X, we'll come back, and when we do tinganta, if someone reminds me, we'll come back and fill the gap here as well. We'll take the example from laghu of ti and si and come and fill it here. Okay, nalop of pratipadikanta. So this is also an important sutra. Pratipadika ending with a nakara and a pada ending with a nakara. If this is a scenario, then that nakara at the end of the pada, which is also at the end of the pratipadika, undergoes lopa. And here, although sakhi is an ikaranta, but still the same sakhi shabda has undergone the modification, not by some special karya like guna, haitya, not a lot of thing has happened there. What has happened is that just this sakhi an was a replacement given here. Therefore, it was a replacement for the pratipadika itself there. So sakhi, the sutra we saw, anangsau, since anangsau is specific for sakhi shabda and pratipadika itself undergoes a change, therefore sakhi becomes sakin when followed by su. Not sakin, sakhan. Sakhan. Therefore, sakhan is a nakaranta pratipadika. So sakhi itself is sakhan, which is a nakaranta pratipadika, and when it becomes sakhan after upada dirgha, that sakhan is a pada after sulopa, and then sakhan, which is a pada, is a nakaranta pada, and it is also nakaranta pratipadika, thereby nalopa pratipadikantasya. But nalopa pratipadikantasya has very wide application, so this is an important sutra. Sakhyu asambuddhu, we don't care much other than sakhi shabda, very rare, so we don't need to do summary of this. But achoniti, what sakhyu asambuddhu? Nidvat syat. When it becomes nidvat, then whatever nit pratyaya can do, similarly, the sarvanamasthane nit, so asambuddhi, in asambuddhi and sarvanamasthana, means all the first five in pullinga and strilinga. But it is sakhi shabda, therefore we don't care about other lingas much. Here when you have sarvanamasthana, so there sudarapunsakasya is sarvanamasthana. And there including prathama 3 and the dvitiya 2, 5 pratyas, sambodhana 2 also, dvitiya and bahuvachana, they are the sthanas which are affected by this sakhyo sambuddho nidvatsya. Thereby nidvat means what? Sakhi plus au will become, will cause au. Au is nidvat, the pratya au is nidvat, and thereby achoniti is invoked. This is an important sutra which will cause vriddhi, angasya vriddhi bhavati. Angasya vriddhi bhavati, here I had shown you some sutras in that section of vriddhi, starting with mrujer vriddhi. Mrujer vriddhi achoniti, and then ataupadayaha, then in taddhita also it is applicable, and kit. So there are this taddhiteshu achamadehe and kit. So taddhite, in taddhita, kit also will cause vriddhi, can cause vriddhi, and ataupadaya. Most of the cases what we'll see is achoniti will cause vriddhi. Vriddhi to what? The last letter. If the last letter is a vowel which can take vriddhi, achoniti will cause vriddhi. So nit or nit pratyaya can cause vriddhi. If the last letter is not a vowel, if it is a consonant, if it is a vowel which cannot take vriddhi, then no application anyway. But if it is a consonant, then ata upadaya. Upadaya means upadha, which is a second last letter. If it is at, taparakaranam has been done, meaning it is a hraswa, akara. akara will undergo vruddhi. So akara can become akara, upada akara can become akara, or the last letter which is a vowel which can take vruddhi will take vruddhi. And in this case sakhi, ikara can take vruddhi, it will become aukara. So sakhau, sorry, aikara, sakhai, sakhai and au, sakhai and au, then echo yavayavah, and we got sakhayau. This is where we were. The reason I revisited this also is because sakhai, sakhai will be an anga which will be common, this part. This will be common for sarvanamasthana. Because sarvanamasthani, this nidvat is what? Sakhyo asambuddhau nidvat. So when you are deriving sakhi, why should you derive the anga again and again? Instead of that, you hold on to sakhai. Sakhai, because angasya sarvanamasthani nidvat syat, therefore anything that is in the sarvanamasthana except asambuddhi, that pratyaya will become nidvat. If it becomes nidvat, then definitely it will cause vriddhi by achoniti. If it causes vriddhi, then you will get sakhai, sakhai as the anga. And sakhai, sakhai plus what follows then? Based on that, the first five pratyayas are what? Su, au, jas. We have already landed on au. So au, then jas. Jas is us. So akaradi, it's also starting with a vowel. Then am is the dvitiya ekvachana pratyaya. Am is also ajadi. Then you have au, the same au in dvitiya dvivachana also. So here dvitiya dvivachana form will also be the same. But I want to point out it is ajadi. And then the last pratyaya, we don't care because first five are done. Sud, sudanapunsakasya. So all these are ajadi pratyas. And they will invoke this echo yavayavaha. Echo yavayavaha they will invoke, and thereby sakhai will become sakhai. So sakhai anga is common in the first five pratyas. Not first five, the first five su has a specific set of sutra. But au, jas, am and out. In these sakhai anga will be common. And then you just add the pratyas. So what will you get? We got earlier what you have seen is, we have seen, I'll just write here and then I'll delete it. We have seen sakhi plus su becomes sakha, sakhan. First sakhan it becomes by an. Then upada dhirga will become sakhan. Then nalopa pratipadikantasya, and thereby you get sakha. So this is the prathama ekvachana. Then what we saw is sakhai. Sakhai. Sakhai anga we derived. Sakhai. There's a bike passing. Some noise. Okay, so sakhai anga we had. This is the anga which is important for the first five. And also sambodhana. Sambodhana we'll see, but sakhai, sakhai plus what will happen? Sakhi. Sakhi. So sakhi plus jas prathama bahuvachana, what will you get? Sakhi plus us. Sakhi plus us, and I'll leave this. We'll land on sakhai. Sakhai plus us. This ellipsis is what we did so far with sakhyo sumbuddhu, and then achonyiti and echo yavayavas. You will enter in sakhai. Us, how do you get? Jakara lopa. By which sutra? Chutu. So chutu will not lopa, but it. Chutu it, and then after that, tasya lopaha. So we have landed in sakhai plus us, which will become sakhai. Sakhayas is sakara will become ru. Sakhayar, and then sakha. Yaha. Repha by what? Sasajusho ru. So ru, and then kharavasani or visarjaniya. Janiha. This is the prathama bhuvachana, which he has mentioned here as sakhayaha. Then what about these others? What happens with others? next is sambuddhi here. Sambuddhi. So here in sambuddhi, some tab issue. Just give me a moment. So sakhaya is prathama bhuvachana and then he sakhe is sambodhana, like hari, no additional sutra, therefore he is just marking them as already done. Hari becomes hare, he hari becomes he hare, so he sakhi becomes he sakhe. Sakhayam, how sakhayam? This sakhay we have already derived. So sakhayam is by sakhi plus am. So sakhay we have already derived. We have already derived sakhay, anga. Add it together, that's all. Sakhayam. So nothing else to be done once you have in sarvanamasthana. Sakhayo we have already derived. This is dvitiya dvivachana. So nothing to be done. Sakin, harivat. So hari becomes, hari shabda becomes harin. Similarly, sakhi becomes sakhin. Sakhya. What happens in sakhya? This is sakhi plus sakhi shabda plus ta. Ta, what will happen here? In hari, what happens? Hari has some specific na coming in. So it becomes hari na. But here, sakhi, there is no specific sutra like hari. So what will you get? Sakhi plus a. Takara goes by which sutra? Against chutu and tasya lopa. Chutu. Tasya lopaha. Okay, this is just a question. Does takara go by chutu or does it go by adir nitudavaha? Think about this. How chutu, whether takara is made it letter by chutu or by adir nitudavaha, because two is there in adir nitudavaha also. In chutu also there is a two. So, which two should take priority? It's a trick question. Please think about it. Is it chutu or adir nitudavaha? It is chutu, but you have to tell me why. So, take this as homework. Why? Not homework. It's a quick resolution. If you have gone through all the it prakarana, if you have studied well, which should be studied well. It should be known by rote. And you should be able to identify immediately as to which sutra should apply for it later. So that is very important. If you have not done it, please spend some time on it sutras, looking at examples and where they'll apply. Which sutra will apply, in which case to make an it later. So sakhi plus a, what happens with sakhi plus a now? Sandhi, what is a sandhi? Sakhi plus A, what's the sandhi? You already have the form sakhya. So obviously and sandhi. So iko yanchi. First sandhi sutra in fact, across all sandhi sutras, first sandhi sutra is iko yanchi. So sakhya plus A by iko yanchi. Iko yanchi and then sakhya is just varnamelanam, nothing else. I'm just writing it separately to point out the yana sandhi. In fact, that's not needed. Sakhya, we can directly write sakhya. Why add another step? Which is not a step at all. So sakhya, sakhya is the form, not sakhyaya, sakhya. Sakhe, what is sakhe? Sakhi plus nye. Prathama, not prathama, sorry. This is दिस इज तृतीय एक वचन एंड दिस इज चतुर्थी एक वचन, चतुर्थी एक वचन सखी प्लस ने. व्हाट हैपेंस? सखी प्लस ए बाय लशक को तद्धि थे लशकु क ख ग ग ङ ङ इज पार्ट ऑफ क वर्गा कु देयरफॉर लस लशक्वत तद्धिते लशक्कु अतद्धिते लशक्वत तद्धिते तद्धिते देन तस्य रूपः. सो व्हाट हैपेंस हियर अगेन इको यणचि सख्य सख्ये यणची. एवरीवेयर एल्स यू जस्ट व्हाट डू यू डू हियर न्यसी न्यसो ही इज नॉट मेंशन इन द अदर्स बिकॉज भ्याम यू जस्ट कीप ऑन एडिंग भ्याम भ्य. नाउ अ न्यू सूत्र अगेन फॉर क्षतिश this khi and thi. For khi and thi there is specific rule and khi is what? Khi is this sakhi khi, khi anta. So khyatyat parasya, khyatyat parasya, what happens? Khyatyat parasya 6 1 1 1 2. Yeah, khyatyat parasya. क्षत्यात्परस्य किं भवति? उत् उतादेश भवति. वेन् न्यसि न्यसुः इन् न्यसि न्यसु स्थान ओन्ली ओन्ली वेन् न्यसि और न्यस् प्रत्यय फॉलोस मीनिंग पंचमी एकवचन और षष्टी एकवचन प्रत्यय फॉलोस देन उत आदेश उत इज द आदेश परस्य ख्यात परस्य सिर्फ पंचमी इज देयर ख्यात एंड षष्टी इज ऑल्सो देयर. इफ पंचमी इज देयर हियर यू डोंट नीड षष्टी बिकॉज षष्टी इज क्लियरली अंडरस्टूड स्थानी इज अंडरस्टूड बाय ख्यात पंचमी. सो ख्य अंतात और त्य अंतात ख्य ख्य अंत और त्य अंत अंगा अंगात परस्य. सो हियर यू सी अंगात व्हाट विल बी दी पदच्छेद ख्यात पंचमी एक वचन परस्य परस्य. षष्टी इज सुपरफ्लुअस हियर. सो व्हाट डज इज अ टीका विच सेज दिस परस्य इज टेकिंग अवे दिस अनुवृत्ति ऑफ दिस पूर्व सवर्ण ऑल इज पूर्व सवर्ण व्हाट एवर इज कमिंग हियर दैट बिकम्स निवृत्त बिकम्स इट सीज इज टू कंटिन्यू फर्दर वेन परस्य इज सेड. सी ऑल दीज मार्किंग्स आर नॉट देर इन सूत्रस दीज आर डन बाय whoever writes their books and how do they get it. So these are marked in sampradaya by studying the tikas and tikas know by sampradaya which says that this akasya savarna dirgha studying the sutras you know this parasya. For example here parasya says that the earlier identification of who is the sani and adesha applies to what this purva savarna. Purva savarna goes till 106 and then some other this purva parayo. See purva parayo ho and purva savarna was an apovada to purva parayo till 106 but because this purva parayo ekah purva parayo goes till 111. How do you know it goes till 111? This purva savarna is from 102 to 106 it's not this thing पूर्व परयो हो एक आदेश विच आदेश ओनली पूर्व पूर्व सवर्ण इज द आदेश पूर्व परयो हो एक आदेश बोथ आर रिप्लेस. स्थानी इज बोथ द पूर्व एंड परा. दिस इज व्हाट इज सेड बाय द 84 सूत्र. हाउ डू यू नो इट गोज टू 111? सो संप्रदाय से परस्य परस्य वॉज सुपरफ्लोस हियर एंड वाई वुड ही हैड परस्य इफ ख्यात वुड हैव डन द वर्क ऑफ आइडेंटिफाइंग द स्थानी. Parasya would have been not necessary and he has wasted if we think of wasting letters in sutra pakara akara refa akara sakara and yakara and akara so many letters the muni has used panini muni has used Why would he use it? He wouldn't have used it unless this had a purpose. And the purpose is to take away this adhikara. Puro parayo will stop when this parasya has come in. Parasya need not go further. Parasya is just to tell you that puro parayo is stopped and khyatyat would anyway identify the sthani as para. So I am just explaining this word parasya. What about khyatyat? So khya and tya. Khya cha tya cha khya. So khyanch, samasa would be khyancha khyancha. Will become khyatyam. Let me cross check samasa. Yeah, so it is samasa. Let's do the samasa and understand the meaning here. It's mardi anuruti. Anuruti is adesha is ut. Ut adesha by ruta ut. From ruta ut. And nyasi nyasoho. Nyasi nyasoho ut. Ut is the adesha. Ut is the adesha. And nyasi nyasoho. Then what do you have? What else do you have? Ati. Ati anyway is nyasi nyasoho ati. So all that is there. Engaha. Engaha is here. All this is. Engaha is going till 110. But ati is going till 113. We can write ati also. Ati. Not of much use because nyasi nyasoho is there. But if nyas and nyas in some case are replaced and they are not ajadi, then this ati will come into play. So khyatyat parasya utadesha nyasignyasoho ati utadesha bhoti. What does he say? Khiti shabdabhyam. Khi and ti. Samasa is what? Khyancha khyancha khyatyam. So this is samahara dvandva. And then tasmat. That will give the samasa for khyatyat. So khyatyat parasya khiti shabdabhyam. Khi shabdabhyam, ti shabdabhyam. So khiti shabdabhyam. Dual. Khi shabdat, ti shabdat. That's what. If you have to split the shabdabhyam dual into singular, you have to say khi shabdat, ti shabdat. And not only hraswa ikara or hraswa tikara. This Dirgha ikara and dirgha khikara and dirgha tikara also are the sthanis, not sthanis, are used to identify the sthani. So khiti shabdabhyam, khiti shabdabhyam, krutayanadesham. This yakara in this is what, if it is khi shabda, what is this ya? Ya is yan. So khi shabda or ti shabda, or khi shabda or ti shabda, dirgha, four of these. The which have taken a yana adesha. Ikara has become yakara. So thereby khi ti shabda will become khya and thya. Krita yana adesha abhyam. Those which have undergone yana adesha. So tabhyam parasya. Krita yana adesha abhyam. Khi ti shabda abhyam. Khi ti shabda abhyam. Parasya. Nyasi nyasoho uhu. So nyasi nyasoho will take uhu adesha. Thereby what will I get? I'll just stop after I finish this since we said a half an hour class. So khi here khi is what? Khi anta. So sa is still there, not just si. So sakhi. So this I'll just split this word to show the khi sitting here. Sakhi plus nyasi. Nyasi or nyas both. Content is same. That's why I'll say nyasi panchami ekvachana and nyas is Shasti ekvachana. When either of this follows, what will happen? Sak. Sakhi plus us. Content of both will be us by Lashakva Taddhite and Tasya Lopaha. We have already done this. So Lashakva Taddhite and Tasya Lopaha. This will take away Nyakara. So us will be the content in both Panchami and Shasti ekvachana. So what happens? Sakhi plus us. You will get Yanadesha. So Sakhya plus us. And so this will be ikoyanachi. By ikoyanachi, sakhya us. Sakhya has become sakhya. meaning what? The Sakhi, again I'll keep it split here. So Sakhi, Sakhi plus Nyasi or Nyas has become Sakhya plus Nyas, and this Khya, Khyanta. So Khiti Shabda Abhyam, Khiti Shabda is Khyanta or Tyanta. So I'll put it in bracket here as what? Khiti. So Kirta Yanadeshabhyam, so I'll put it as in bracket in the Vritti, or here I'll write it here itself. Khyatyat is equal to this is Khya, because Angasya is there, or rather I'll put Angasya Vritti here. Angasya, if you put Angasya here, since it is Sutra which is in Shashto Adhyaya, Angadikara. So Angasya can be changed to Angat. Will become Angat, Panchami Ekvachana. Then Tadanta Vidhi you can apply Khyatyat Angat means what? Khyadantat Angat. Khyatyantat Angat. Not Khyadantat. Khyadantat, Khyadantat Angat. So this means Khyadanta Shabdabhyam means what? Khiti Shabdabhyam means what? Krutayanadeshabhyam. This will now be, will mean equal to Khyatyant. So Khyantat Angat. Khyantat Angat or Angat or Khyantat Angat. Angat. Parasya Nyasi Nyaso. Ataha ut. So ataha ut. Ataha is also there, of course. Here ataha is there. Ataha ut. Which, so ataha. Ataha, if you look at ataha here. Here you have ataha from. Enga padantad ati. So, just a second. Somewhere there is a vibhakti parinama. Let me check from which sutra. Yeah, Eng of Padantad Ati. So, Eng of Padantad Ati, this Ati, yeah, Ati which goes to 113. This Ati which goes to 113, yeah, that's why I'm saying Ati, what is used here? This Ati which goes to 113, this becomes Ataha by Vibhakti Parinama and thereby Shakti Ekvachana. You have Stani. Otherwise, what will happen is Ati, if it remains Saptami, then also it would work. But Sthani would be what? This Angat. No, it will not work because Panchami Baliyan. Panchami and Saptami and both are there. Then Panchami will become Baliyan. And what will happen is that the Khyatyat Angat. Khyatyat Angat. Just a second, let me think. Hi Shabdabhyam, Ti Shabdabhyam, Krutayana Deshabhyam. So, the Tikas is, this is a little tricky because Khi and Tia, Khya and Tia, we don't know what it means. Khya, anyway, I have to still look up, but Khya, here interestingly he says, Akara, Atha Akara, yeah, Akara will take, I don't know why it is needed. Panchami and Saptami Ataha. Personally, I don't know why this Ataha it has become. Since the Vritti says Ataha, I have to look up Ataha. Otherwise, without Ataha, I thought we could still manage. Okay, perhaps for a reason. See what has happened. This. So it's a little. This Khyatya, this Akara. See what Akara is here, Krita Yanadesha, Krita Yanadeshabhyam has been said. This Yanadesha will leave a Yakara ending Anga, this kind of an Anga. Since Akara here in the Sutra is Uccharanartha, this Khyatyat Parasya. Otherwise you would have got what? Khyatyaha Parasya. You don't get Khyatyaha Parasya, you get Khyatyat Parasya. That Akara is Uccharanartha. This Akara is Uccharanartha. Otherwise you will have to include this fellow also, this Akara also. But this Akara is not part of the Anga. This is a Pratyaya Akara. So, akara here is for uchcharana in this sutra, khyatyatparasya. So, if that akara is uchcharanartha, here he is indicating that which is the sthani then. This akara is the sthani. Thereby, akara is to be replaced. Ataha. Otherwise, what will happen? Yeah, another reason is that ati. If you don't have ataha, then what will happen is that sthani, I can still bring in I can still manage with paribhasha, but then it is not clear with akara here, sitting here. So, where we can say ucharanartha akara and sakhi, that sakhya which has become sakhya yanadesha, which has taken yanadesha, the akara here is ucharanartha, khyatyat, in khyatyat, khyatya, khyatya like Rama, that akara is ucharanartha, and tasmat parasya akarasya, this ataha. Ut adeshasya, this akara will be replaced by ut. So I'll mark this with an underline and this will take sakhya plus u adesha. Sakara is still there. The sakara will still remain u adesha by our current sutra by khyatya parasya. Sorry, I'm going on for 7 minutes. Anyway, I'll stop here by saying sakhyuhu. You will get sakyus and then sakyur and then sakyuhu. Same sutras that we saw earlier. So sakyuhu. This is in Panchami Ekvachana as well as Shashti Ekvachana. Okay, so we'll stop here. And I wanted to see some more sutras. But anyway, we'll see it in the next part. Huh? Nattavasane nataraja rajo nanna dadakkannava panchavaram uddhartu kamas sanakadi siddhan etad vimarshe shiva sutra jalam. Any questions? Okay, just a second. I'll look up if Kashika gives any. Yeah, there are some. Okay, there are some examples for Tiyanta in Kashika. I'll see if any of this can be covered up now. Otherwise, we'll see in Tinganta. What's the question?
Sakhi 2-3,
yeah.
That declines like Hari Shabda, no?
Yeah, you'll get Sakhi.
Because it is not in Sarvanamasthana.
Yeah, it is not in Sarvanamasthana.
And there I think Tasma Chasoho, Naposi. The Nakara comes in there because of that.
Yeah, yeah, Nakara will come in Upada Dirgha. And then you'll get Sakhin. So what you saw.
Yeah, so my question was I couldn't find a good explanation for Tadanta Vidhi and Tadadi Vidhi. Could you please briefly explain it?
It's very basic, Amma. You should know this.
That's what I just seem to have forgotten.
See, Tadanta Vidhi is when you have a Visheshana, Visheshana Vishesha Sambandha, then the Visheshana takes Tadanta, Tadanta Vidhi, that is called as Tadanta Vidhi. Vishesha takes Anta, Anta Shabda. So whatever is the word, in whichever case, Prathama to Saptami, in any case if you have two words in Samanadi Karani with a Visheshana Vishesha Sambandha, like what we saw right now is this Khyatyat. So this Angasya and Khyatyat. Or say ataha, ataha and anga. What happens when this angasya has become angat? Had it remained angasya, then ataha and angasya would have been samanadhikaranam because ati has also undergone vibhakti parinama. So this is a little complicated. I'll take this example of angat and khyatyat. So if angat and khyatyat are in samanadhikaranyam, this is panchami ekvachana, this is also panchami ekvachana, but they are in samanadhikaranyam as well because khyatya is an anga. but it is in panchami now. So whichever be the case, khyatyah angaha or khyatyam angam, I'm just giving an example, none of this is there in the sutra, but panchami, shashti, saptami we see in sutra. Tritiya also. But let's say khyatyat angat or khyatyasya angasya, I'll take atah, a good example for this would be ato dirgo yani. So I'll just take an example here itself. There is a question, and this is fundamental. So if people who don't understand, please stick on. I'm assuming that everyone understands this. So,
ato, no, I missed the first few classes.
Dirgho yani. Yani. So, there is a sutra, ato dirgho yani. Okay, so what is ataha? Ataha is. Ato is ataha dirgha is the adesha. So this is all an aside. So ato dirgha yani. What will happen here? Ataha dirgha yani. And in bracket, this is sutra number. Let me see. Approximately, I'll give you approximately. Ato dirgha. 73101. Okay, so 73101 sutra says ato dirgho yani, where so this is 73101 says anga adhikara, angasya, say angasya is the, so what will be the vritti now, how will you make up the vritti? Ataha is shashti ekvachana, taparas tatkalasya, so akara, ata is akara. Akarasya. Ataha means akarasya. So I'll say akarasya here. Akarasya angasya. Or adantasya angasya. How will you get adantasya angasya? Dirgaha is the adesha. And yani. Yani. What is yan? This is yan is a pratyahara. So yan. Yan. Yan and then yan is a pratyaya. So I can add pratyaya here. Pratyaye pare. Saptami. Saptami I can add because what follows an anga will be a pratyaya here. So pratyaye in saptami I can add because yani is in saptami and yani is what follows parasaptami. So parasaptami which is a pratyaya, therefore pratyaya yani pratyaye I can add. So now if I have to make a vritti myself, how will I make a vritti? Ataha and ataha or akarasya, same meaning, akarasya, angasya, I'll put them together. And then I'll say yani. Yani pratyaye. Pratyaye pare, parasaptami. What will be the adesha? Dhirgha adeshaha bhavati or syat. Ataha or akarasya angasya yani pratyaye pare dhirgha adesha bhavati. Now what is ataha? Is akara and it is in shashti ekvachana, qualifies anga. Will all akara take dirgha adesha when followed by yan? No, it should be an anga. Anga akara. Okay, then yani. When yan follows, can any yan follow? No, it should be a pratyaya yan. So these are so many conditions. Thereby, what happens? This anga is qualified by akara, is limited. Vishesh, anga is a visheshana. It is qualified by ataha. So it should be an anga having an at. So at will take an adesha. At will, because anga will take an adesha, which anga? At anga will take an adesha. Adesha will be applied to the last of the anga. The last letter will take adesha, not the entire anga. So at is a qualification or akara is a qualification visheshana for this visheshya anga. Similarly, pratyaya is qualified by yan. Yan pratyaya. And yan is a pratyahara. So whatever is included, yan. Yan pratyahara is a, it's a letter. Now what is said is that, Tadanta Vidhi says that, whenever you see this vishesha, visheshana visheshya sambandha, here also visheshana visheshya sambandha, then you add Tadanta Vidhi. Tadanta Vidhi means what? You will see whatever is tat is here at. Here tat is yan. So tadanta is adanta vidhi here and yanyanta vidhi here. Tat is a pronoun. You have to replace with the noun. Which is the noun? Tadanta vidhi, if it applies here, then it will become adanta or akaranta. Here, if it applies, it will become yanyanta or yalanta. It will become yanyanta. So, what is it saying is that whatever is, whichever visheshana qualifies the vishesha, when a vidhi is given, that vidhi will not apply to only to that, it will apply to its anta. Not only in some cases only, but it will apply to its anta. So, not to ath, since ath, all adeshas are to the anta. Anta, because alonkyasya. Alonkyasya, thereby adantasya. Alonkyasya, which is the al here, ath or akara. So, anga ending in ath or akara is the idea by saying ataha dirgaha. So, adantasya dirgha bhavati. Adantasya angasya dirgha bhavati. Thereby, what will happen? Ath. Ath is tat here. So, in tadanta vidhi, tat. So, tadanta vidhi will be what? Tadanta vidhi is equal to ath. Adanta vidhi here. Ath. Anta. So, you can drop this vibhakti here. Whichever is the, this is a shashti vibhakti. You drop the shashti vibhakti, what do you get? Ath. You get ath or akara. And then, so you have either at or akara, and then you add anta, anta word to it. So tat anta vidhi. Tat anta vidhi is what? You add anta to tat. And tat being the pronoun, your noun is at or akara or yan. Thereby you add anta word and then vidhi is added. So akara anta, you will get the pratipadika instead of at you will get, or akara you will get ad or you adanta, or you will get akaranta. Then you bring back the vibhakti. Vibhakti is what? Shashti. So thereby you add the vibhakti. Vibhakti here you will get antasya. Antasya, and here also you will get antasya. If you had panchami here, you would get antat. So you drop the vibhakti and add antat. So tadanta vidhi will bring you tadantat or tadantasya in panchami and shashti. So here it is shashti, so we will take adantasya, akarantasya, angasya. Adantasya or akarantasya, angasya, yani pratyaya pari. Now if you add yan, to yan, you replace tat with yan, tadanta vidhi, you will get yanyanta. But yanyanta pratyaya makes no sense here. Because you already have tadanta, angasya, and sandhi, generally when, this is a sandhi sutra, sandhi is not between the last letter of the anga and the last letter of the pratyaya, unless the pratyaya itself is a single letter, which is not the case. So what happens here is when yan is said, yan is a single letter, but not single letter pratyayas you barely see. So pratyaya is, say you have, let's say kya pratyaya or so you'll have at least two letters. Generally you'll have at least two letters in a pratyaya. Ti, sip, ti, all these. So su, aujas, am, aujas. Very rarely you see single letters. There are single letters. But still the sandhi is between what? It should be applicable with a single letter, two letter, three letter, any number of pratyaya. It should apply. So yan is what really, starting with yan, not the last letter. Because sandhi is not with the last letter of the pratyaya and the last letter of the anga. It is between the first letter of the pratyaya. Therefore, here there is an apavada to tadanta vidhi which says that unless there is a saptami and is a single letter, saptami is a single letter. If you have, let's say, some word follows, then you do this. Some particular sandhi is in samasas. Only when it is followed by this word, then some sandhi. That word should be a complete word. It cannot be a single letter. So, in those cases, it's a different matter. But yan is a single letter. So, when a saptami vidhi has been indicated by saptami and it is a single letter, then it says that the tadanta vidhi should be replaced by tadadi vidhi, meaning instead of anta which we added here, we have to add adi to make the vritti. Thereby yan will be what? Yan tat anta and tat adi. So tadadi will be yan adi. Yan adi, and which case is yani pratyaya?
Seven.
Saptami ekvachana. So if you adi, if you decline in saptami ekvachana, what will you get? Like hari. Saptami ekvachana. हरौ सो आदौ यण्यादौ प्रत्यये परे सो यू दिस विल बिकम आदि विल बिकम आदौ इन सप्तमी सो यण्यादौ प्रत्यये परे नाउ हैव योर वृत्ति व्हाट डज इट मीन परे दीर्घ आदेश भवति सो नाउ इफ यू रीवर्ड दिस मेक एन अन्वय यू विल गेट यण्यादौ यण्यादौ प्रत्यये परे अदन्तस्य अंगस्य दीर्घः आदेशः भवति दिस इज योर वृत्ति दिस इज व्हाट तदंत एंड तदादि विधि इज अंडरस्टूड
या सो तदंत विधि कैन टेक एनी विभक्ति बट तद आदि इज ओनली सप्तमी
सप्तमी एंड इट शुड बी सिंगल लेटर विधि इंडिकेटेड बाय सिंगल लेटर only then it will be a vidhi so tadanta vidhi will be what I forgot the sutra itself because we are used to saying tadanta vidhi yasmad vidhi just a second yasmad pratyay vidhi tadadau yasmad pratyay vidhi this is an Anga definition. I've forgotten the sutra, so, but it will come. Yasmin Tadadu. I think it's not a sutra. The Saptami is it's an apuada by Vartika. I don't recall where it is. We have seen this sutra. Anyone else online? Does anyone remember? I have. Since we use it so many times, does anyone remember the sutra for Tadanta Vidhi? I am getting confused with Anga. Anga is Tasu Tasmod. Anyway, I'll tell you in the next part. Go back and look up the sutras that we have done. At least read the sutras, in that you will get it. I have mentioned this elaborately multiple times, so you will find it earlier also. Just let me see in this itself. Partha we should be able to search here itself. Algrahani, if I search, we should get it. Algrahani is what I remember. Algrahani. Algrahani. Do we have? ग्रहणी प्रत्यय तदादु यस्मिन् विधि तदादु अलग्रहणी सो तदंत विधि येन विधि तदंतस्य ओके सो येन विधि तदंतस्य इति सूत्र येन विधि हि तदंतस्य येन विधीयते तद अंतस्य भवति तदंतस्य दैट इज तदंत विधि दिस कॉल्ड एज येन विधि तदंतस्य इति सूत्र दिस इज अ सूत्र दिस सूत्र इज कॉल्ड एज तदंत विधि एक्चुअली आई शुड हैव सर्च फॉर तदंत विधि इटसेल्फ एंड तदादि विधि इज व्हाट वार्तिका सेज दैट यस्मिन् विधि हि तदादौ अलग्रहणे यस्मिन् विधि सो यस्मिन् विधि तदादौ अलग्रहणे व्हेन यस्मिन् अलग्रहणे इंसटेड ऑफ दिस अंत इफ देयर इज एन अलग्रहण विद अ सप्तमी यस्मिन् देन दैट विधि विल टेक आदि and it will apply to Adi and Adi will take this Yasmin case Saptami and you will get Adau Tadadu Algrahani Saptami okay I think Bhavya got disconnected I hope the answer is sufficient I'll change the next part up Namaste see this is the issue if you you keep on using instead of the sutras we use short forms see for example Ayadi Sandhi or Yan Sandhi We forget the sutra. I mean, at least I forget the sutra. Unless we say eko yanachi or echo yava yava, we are used to saying, see, visarga sandhi. Actually, it is not a visarga sandhi at all. Laghu calls it visarga sandhi. But what is the sutra? Visarga is not even born and we call it a visarga sandhi. Some places. And under visarga sandhi, we club quite a few things. Thereby, there is a tendency to forget the sutra. So it's easy to say, you know, dirgha sandhi. Savarna Dirgha Sandhi. But what is the sutra? You can't recall. when we say savarna dirgha or dirgha sandhi or savarna dirgha sandhi, we forget the sutra itself because we know what is happening and we say savarna dirgha sandhi. But akas savarne dirgha, you'll forget that akas savarne dirgha. Savarna dirgha and akas savarne dirgha, there is a difference. Actually, in effect, there is no difference. But in sampradaya, we use these words as tadanta vidhi, savarna dirgha sandhi, yana sandhi. Because these are common across those who study Vyakarana with and without sutras. Thereby, yana sandhi has become very common. Iko yana chi, people forget in time. But yana sandhi, people will remember. Similarly, visarga sandhi or tadadi vidhi, tadanta vidhi. We forget the vartika, we forget the sutra. So it's better to say, try to recall these sutras when possible. And I'm telling as a mental note to myself also. Yena vidhis tadantasya and yasmin vidhis tadadu alagrahane. They are so common that in short we use tadanta vidhi and tadadi vidhi. Okay? Namaste. Any questions, Bhavya? Anything else? Okay, we have ended up with a 1 hour class anyway. Namaste. See you in the next part. Huh?